For the lean PCOS people, the problem of insulin resistance will still be there. It may be a lot more managed, but it is going to be there. So the carb intake has to be limited no matter what. We cannot ever, the minute you know that you have PCOS, no matter what your weight, you have to, for life, you have to keep your carb intake a little low and your fat intake a little more. Now, for the lean people, what you do is you increase your protein and your fat intake a little bit more. When you increase, so with insulin resistance, the thing is your muscle mass is actually your strength, because the muscle actually improves insulin sensitivity. So what you do is, if you're a lean PCOS, you should increase the amount of protein that you take, and you need to focus on the fat that you're taking. Now, when you do these two, what's going to happen is that you're going to, the protein is going to help your muscles build. It's also, protein and fat together are raw material for a lot of the hormones that are manufactured. So when you're taking good amounts of both of these and in good quality, then a lot of your hormonal imbalance will get corrected. So this is one thing. And for lean PCOS, again, weight training becomes very, very important. This is actually important for all forms of PCOS, but weight training becomes very important. And the last thing with lean PCOS is you have to understand, why are you getting it? Sometimes it can be a genetic predisposition, but there is something that's going wrong in your lifestyle, and typically it's going to be stress. So you want to manage the stress. In order to manage the stress, what you can do is you can either look at, I know like pranayama helps, meditation helps, but what you really need to do is you need to learn how to manage your stress on an everyday basis. Because typically women have the habit of wanting to do everything, and we want to do everything right. It's the most woman-like thing to do, and that causes stress. So something that I do, and I tell a lot of my clients, is that in the middle of the day, maybe do it 3 to 4 times, just close your eyes and take 3 deep breaths. When you do this, suddenly your entire stress level will reduce and you'll feel a lot more oriented. So if you start building this habit, what you'll realize is that everyday stress, which, you know, in retrospect, you're like, why was I even stressing about it? A lot of those small, small things will just not bother you enough. So with lean PCOS, stress is what you have to manage and sleep is what you have to manage. They're both related. So focus on these. You want to do about 40% carbs, 30% protein and 30% fat. Having said this, I did give you this breakup because, you know, you're going to be listening to this and trying it on your own. But please don't get bogged down into macros and, you know, calorie counting, because personally, none of my clients are ever, you know, on a calorie counted diet or a protein rich diet like that. You just want to make sure that, like, do this in the beginning to understand it, but don't get into the habit of counting your carbs and your protein and everything.